Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. I hope you guys are all doing well. Today's video is about period loss birth control, and this was probably one of the most requested videos ever. I touched base in my latest Cover Talk video on my experience with period loss, and I just got so many questions in my DMs and also in the comments from people who could really like relate or had the same problem or just had a lot of questions about this. Honestly, it's been a journey. Before we're getting into today's video, I actually have some special news. Upcoming Sunday, I will be hosting a live cooking workshop on Zoom with Homemade for UNICEF. So you can buy tickets. I will link them in the description down below. All the proceeds will be donated to the COVID relief funds for UNICEF. So it is for a good cause. Okay, where are we going to start? First of all, this video is really not about me giving advice on what you should do, because I'm not a doctor, and second of all bodies are different. All bodies respond on different things. In this video, I just really wanted to share my personal experience, and this could maybe be helpful, maybe can give you inspiration. It's just like interesting to hear, I guess. I kind of wanted to touch base on two different things, period loss and birth control, because they are both going really hand in hand. So I will mix kind of both of them into my whole like journey. Let's start about my first period. I was actually 16 years old when I got my period for the first time, and this was actually pretty late. I remember all my friends already got their period when they were 13, 14. I was a professional acrobat at that time, so I was exercising and training a lot, about like 15 hours a week. So often like young athletes or people who do a lot of sports actually don't have their period, or they will come a little later. I was also like really, really skinny, so probably a combination of all. So I got my first period when I was 16. It was never really regular, it was very light, and in a way I was like pretty lucky with it, because I didn't have cramps, I didn't feel bad about it, I didn't experience those like negative sides. And then I started working full-time when I was 18. I started traveling the world. I moved to New York and I was working a lot. At this point, I actually just got on birth control. I wanted to try the IUD in Mirena. And the reason why I wanted to try this was, I think most of my friends actually had the pill, but I was kind of freaked out by the pill, because so many people had really good experience with it, while their acne would clear up, they would feel sometimes much better, and then the other half would kind of gain a lot of weight, did not feel really good. And I just saw the really strong effect of the pill with the hormones in there. And I was just not really about that. Already, like very early on, I was like, I just don't really want to put that in my body. I don't even want to try it. So I chose the Mirena IUD. And this is just a really tiny one. I'll pop up a picture here. You go to the doctor, they just like put this right in here in your ovary, and it stays in there for like 5 years. You actually don't get your period on this anymore, which was for a lot of girls, I think, a really pro, because periods kind of suck. It's weird, we kind of want them, but like they're also, when it's there, like it's not really fun. Absolutely no. So yeah, I got that one, and I had an extremely bloated stomach from this, and this is supposed to be normal and it should disappear after 2 months, and for me it didn't disappear. After 4 months it was still super bloated, and I was like crying way more on like random moments. And for some reason, I think it's really hard to explain, I just didn't really feel myself. Yeah, I just noticed the hormones had some kind of effect on me. So I actually, after I think half a year, 6 months, I took it out, which was not really pleasant. Well, it's not as scary as people think. They just like, you know, they open up your legs, they put this thing in there and they just take it out. And it's almost like a feel like a really a small cramp or something. And then it's over. It's really not that big of a deal. So then kind of my whole period loss started. My period was always already very light, And at one point, you know, didn't came for 1 month, for 2 months, three, it was almost gone for a year. And there are actually a lot of different reasons why you can have period loss. This could be a hormonal imbalance with your estrogen, This could be your lifestyle with over-exercising or not eating enough. It could also be with medication and obviously different types of birth control. So in this case, I was just kind of a little bit worried about it. So I went to see a doctor, and the doctor kind of, you know, she was like, what's your lifestyle like? And I like explained to her, I'm like, well, I live kind of in New York, but I'm every week in Europe, I'm working and like traveling. And she looked at me and she was like, first of all, your fat percentage should probably be a little bit higher, and your lifestyle, there is no rhythm. If you are up and down to the US and Europe all the time, your how can you expect your body to have a rhythm when you're constantly in jet lags and your life is not in a rhythm? And I was like, that makes sense. So she recommended obviously to get my fat percentages a little bit up. She also understood that too much of that was not really possible because of the industry I was in. And I do think like 5-6 years ago when I was doing shows, the size zero was a very like important thing. All the girls had to be so skinny to like fit in the sample sizes. And I feel also that in a way that time I would be a little bit scared to gain weight, because that's kind of what my job was and how I was getting booked on all these shows and things, and obviously who I was, whatever, but also the way you like fit clothes. I'm gonna be honest, like I did feel a bit scared, and that doctor kind of like realized that as well. She was like, okay, just like, you know, incorporate a lot of healthy fats like avocado, salmon, sunflower seeds, almond butter. So that's what I did. And she recommended me as a birth control the Nova Ring, which actually has a little bit of hormones in there, a very tiny amount. So basically what this birth control is, it is a round ring, a rubber ring. It's kind of like bendable, and you place this into your vagina and it stays there for a month. You can still have sex with this. You don't really feel this, and it just gives off this tiny bit of hormone into your body. And this is why you obviously don't get pregnant. So I tried that for a couple months, and again, the same thing, the tiny bit of hormones just like affected me emotionally so much. I did not feel myself. I would cry at like random moments and all these things. And each month you take it out and you put a new one in. And I just was like not really a huge fan of like that feeling. And again, like hormones, I didn't have a boyfriend at the time. So I was like, you know what? I just want to take the thing out. I just want to feel natural and kind of like figure this out. So after a couple months, I took that out as well and I stopped using it. So I was on a period of time again that I was not using birth control. And the weird thing was I got my period back for a couple of months, and I have no idea from what this exactly was. It just like came back after a couple of months. It was like gone again. So I just also couldn't really figure out what it was, because my body fat percentage was exactly the same as before. I wanted to try a new birth control, and all the ones with hormones didn't really work for me. So I wanted to try the copper IUD. So I know that this one is actually really not recommended in the US, but my doctor in Europe told me about this. It's like an IUD, it's a little copper one. They place this inside you and it stays for 10 years, which is also pretty nice. But the only downside to this is that your periods get really, really heavy. You're bleeding way more. Some people get intense cramps. It's emotional, like it's just like really heavy. I was never really used to that because my periods were always like very light. So when I got the IUD, I actually, you know, I had my period. It was like pretty regular. It was back for another like 2 years. But I did like start thinking a little bit. I was like, is my natural body having a cycle right now? Or is this because of this IUD? And I mean, I'm not a doctor at all. And I was kind of like, I wonder if I take it out, if it's going to be there, yes or no. And I think about 1.5 years ago, I started losing my period again. And this was kind of a moment where I was like, okay, I kind of want to take this more serious right now. You know, a lot of like friends and like people around me were either trying to get pregnant or like were pregnant. And it just like kind of started to make me think that I was like, wait, I want to have kids in the future too. So I almost felt like, is there something wrong with me? How can I fix this? This was just like really, really hard. So I started working with my trainer and he was like, okay, your body fat percentage is actually really, really low. And we are just gonna try to see if changes in your diet will make a difference. I had to incorporate more whole grains, so more like oats, bulgur, or like rice, some more like carbs. Obviously healthy fats like salmon, avocado, seeds, sunflower seeds, and like almond butter, peanut butter, like put more scoops in there to kind of get my body percentage up. Because at that point, it was not really over-exercising, I think. So I started integrating way more like foods into my diet, and I even presented my whole diet to like doctors and like even the, you know, the trainer, and everyone looked at it and was like, well, this looks really, really healthy. We started to figure out like after a couple months that food was not, you know, the diet didn't really like help that much. And doctor actually looked at me and he was like, I have a feeling it's actually about stress. I think we really often forget about the impact stress can have on our body. It can show in hair loss, it can show in hair gaining weight or losing weight, skin rashes, like in all these like weird things, in a headache or whatever. I kind of have shared a lot with you guys from the last year over, you know, I was going through like some harder period of times and like stressful times. I didn't really know what I was like doing anymore. I had a healthy lifestyle, but it was just so frustrating to me. It was like, why is my period like not coming back? So at this point, I also had my IUD and I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna take my IUD out as well. I just don't want anything in my body, anything to do with birth control, and just really solve this problem without any like external or like internal probably other factors. Let's keep it that way. And then after 6 months, my period came back, which was obviously a big like cheer moment. And at the same time, I was like, oh, it's gonna start again. I think in my case, it had probably a lot to do with stress. And I've really worked on kind of my stress management and how I, you know, how I like fix this. And actually, I wanna discuss this in my next coffee talk video because Jason has helped a lot with this. And I just really think like to be more kind to my body and to listen more to my body has really helped in that sense would be, you know, taking longer breaks, like going on little getaways or hanging out more with like friends or like being outside, substituting a workout for maybe just like a walk outside, having more meals with like pizzas or whatever, just like what feeds your soul as well. And I think, and kind of, yeah, to really be kind to yourself, not only through nutrition or like exercise, but just also kind of like mentally, has just like really helped, I guess. I really think there is just not a one answer for this. What exactly is the cause? Obviously, you can, you know, get checked by a doctor. Honestly, it's been like it's been really a journey. And for everyone now, we'll probably ask, so what are you using for birth control right now? I actually do not have any birth control. I'm using the app Flow. And this actually really amazing app. I actually got this, was recommended by Emily Di Donato. I started posting about it and like I started reading it. You can basically track your period and you can see on which days you're ovulating, and this way you can kind of know like, okay, you're like, you know, be careful or whatever. This is definitely not recommended for everyone and there's definitely potential risk for this. And no, I'm definitely not trying to get pregnant because that's the last thing, or not the last thing. I'm just like, not good timing right now. I just like really hope that this was helpful maybe to listen to. I hope it was not too much of a weird, like all over the place. So I got some questions from you guys as well. So what do you think is the reason you lost your period and for how long? again. I think this was really an overall balance between my mental state, between stress, and maybe nutrition as well. Was gaining weight a must? Was it hard? It was actually pretty hard for me because I don't really gain weight that fast, and this sounds like really amazing, but if you have to like eat a lot of food and like kind of overeat yourself till a point you're feeling not so great, it's honestly not a great feeling. And it's just also kind of like weird to start gaining weight. I feel, you know, your clothes don't really fit, and like at the beginning I felt a bit uncomfortable with it, but then like after a while it was kind of like, oh, I kind of like it, you know. It's got like more boobs, like more feminine curves, and like I was into it. It took a long time after that before my period came back. I don't think that was the real reason. This is a really good question. What kind of lifestyle and eating habits did you have when you lost your period? For example, low carb, low fat diet, stress. For me, it was a very irregular like lifestyle with like travel. It was a lot of stress. I was like trying to run too many businesses and things like at the same time, managing career with friends, with boyfriends, and all these things. I think I had a low carb diet. Also probably because I was like still in my head trying to fit in those standard sizes what the modeling industry wanted. And I think I've also really let go of that over the last year. And I think this is a really good thing about the whole industry, that this is kind of changing, that girls don't have to be like skinny, 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 that they just need to look healthy and strong. And I think this is so important because honestly, when I look into the industry, my friends and all the girls, like so many of them all have like problems with like periods and stuff, and like a negative body image, even though they're one of the most like beautiful girls out there. And I think it's a really good thing that that's kind of like shifting, and there's more room for like diversity, and especially in size. While working on it, getting back, did you work out? And if so, what kind of exercise did you do? Again, I was just like a little bit more kind to my body, like working out maybe like 3 or 4 times a week instead of like 5. I was not doing cardio really anymore. So more like low intensity with like Pilates and stuff, and kind of a switch. And actually, another thing, this is a really good question. I incorporated more weight training because weight training is really good for women to build up extra estrogen. I think I'm never going to be able to pronounce these words. Kind of weight training and muscle training helps with that. So that's why I got into more training with weights, because my body kind of like needed that. Well, yeah, I hope I answered most of you guys' questions. I know it was just like a lot of information. Again, this is just has been my experience, and this is for everyone different because every body is different. My main tip would just be to be, if you're struggling with like period loss, to just be really kind to yourself. Get maybe tested and like see if there are any like hormonal imbalances, and like, you know, if the problem is a little bit deeper than, or if it's more like your lifestyle, or yeah, trying to find the root cause. And honestly, still I'm like now 25 and my period has come back, and it's actually still not regular, but yeah, it is what it is. I'm happy it's back, and I'm happy now. I feel more relaxed, and I think at the end, like, that's the most important. And I will go into it in another video too, like how I kind of fixed the stress management together with Jason. And if you guys have any other questions for me, please don't hesitate to send me a DM on Instagram. I will try to respond to everything, and obviously comment down below in this video. I love you guys very much. And don't forget, UNICEF this Sunday. See you guys.